Hey everyone, Mr. MC here. This is guide for Circuit to Spa-Francorchamps with the Group 1 cars. For the qualifying time trial session, we'll be using the 2016 Audi R18, and for the race session, we'll be using the Toyota TSO50. And as you're starting your time trial session, use both braking and throttle at the same time to recharge the battery before you're pointing towards the start-finish line. Start on the second gear. So you're going to bring yourself to the left side of the track and you want to brake before you reach the 100 meter board. You're going to be braking hard for a short while, slowly ease off of the brakes as you turn in. Briefly go down to first gear for extra rotation, then back up to second gear. Have the car pointing down the hill as soon as you can before you fully accelerate, as the boost will make the car extremely understeery. This part can be taken flat out. Just take advantage of the curb on the left, then turn in, get on the curb on the right, and then get on the curb on the left again. The less turning input you use, the more speed you keep, which means that you'll be able to get a faster lap time. Now bring yourself to the left, look for the 100 meter board as that is your next braking point. Brake hard for a short while, then slowly ease off of the brakes as you turn in. You're going to need to do a lot of throttle control to try to retain your speed and still keep control of the car. Bring yourself to the left, ease off of throttle, and right as you hit the apex, you can then start to fully accelerate. Then brake before the curb on the left starts. You're going to be braking hard for a short while. Slowly ease off of the brakes so the car doesn't start to slide. You can exit this turn on third gear, bring yourself to the right. Brake a little early for this turn and use a little bit of braking to fine-tune the car, have a point towards the next section of the track, and fully accelerate. Stay on the right side of the track, look for the black digital flag that is on the right as that is your next braking point. Brake hard for a super short moment, then quickly start to ease off the brakes. Get on the throttle as early as you can so you can try to maximize your speed as you exit the turns. Then brake before the curb on the left starts, brake hard for a short moment, and slowly ease off of the brakes as you go through this right turn. Do a little bit of throttle control as you go through this left turn. Then bring yourself to the left, brake before the curb on the left starts, brake hard for a short moment, and quickly ease off of the brakes to try to get the car to rotate through this turn. Take this right turn flat out, do not hit the bollard that's at the apex. Let's go ahead and fast forward through this. You can take this left turn flat out, then stay to the right side of the track. Slowly bring yourself to the left and brake just before you reach the 150 meter mark. You're going to be braking hard for a while. Carefully ease off of the brakes as you turn in. Try to hit the apexes, get the car pointing towards the start finish line, and then fully accelerate. That is pretty much it for the lap guide. Let's go ahead and take a look at the strategies. For this race, we are doing 10 laps at Circuit de Spa-Francorchamps with the Group 1 cars, and we only have the racing hard tires to work with, so there are no tire requirements. The fuel is at times 2, and the tire wear is at times 6, and with these values not really affecting the car that much, this is going to be a pretty easy no stop. And you do want to be careful as you start the race. For this first turn, brake at around or just before the 100 meter board, and be nice and careful because your tires are pretty cold and your car is full of fuel, so your car is going to handle a bit differently than how it does on the time trial. And you also want to be careful as you go all the way down the straight, because you will need to brake just a little bit earlier, and it's going to be really easy to overshoot this braking point, which is what you're about to see right now. So I braked at the 100 meter board, which is going to be a little too late. Brake just before the 100 meter board, that way you don't end up running the risk of overshooting that turn. And just don't overpush the car for the first lap, and by the time you're starting your second lap, your tires should be warmed up and then you can start to push a little bit more. You also want to make sure that you can try to qualify at least fourth place, as that means that you'll get a chance to battle it out with first, second, third, and fourth place. If you're starting fifth, sixth, seventh, or eighth place, you are starting in the middle of the chicane, so you have to be extra careful as you exit the chicane, which is going to already give you a pretty big disadvantage over catching up to 4th place and above. And finally, there's only one penalty serving zone, and it's going to be at the Kimmel Straight. So if you get a track penalty or a contact penalty or a stupid penalty, you're going to have to serve it there. But anyways, let's go ahead and quickly talk about the strategies, and there's actually not going to be much to talk about, as once again, this is a pretty easy no-stop race. With the fuel at times 2, it's not going to present a problem at all for these 10 laps, so you don't have to worry about refueling or anything like that. When it comes to the tire wear, the most that you have to do is adjust the brake balance setting and you are pretty much good to go. So for example, with the Toyota TS050, the front tires wear out a little bit faster than the rear tires, so I'm going to bring the brake balance to the rear of the car. In this case, I had it at +3, and that was pretty much it. I don't have to worry about the tire wear for this race, and I was pretty much good to go. The tire wear isn't really going to present much of an issue at all in this race, and this is assuming you're always under the clean air. Now, if you're within 3/4 of a second behind someone, you're going to be under the dirty air. On the high-speed sections like the Kimmel Straight, that's not going to present a problem, as that's pretty much your slipstream. You're going to be catching up to them as your car is accelerating faster. But as you go through the twistier parts of the circuit, your car is going to be a bit more understeery because your car, under the dirty air, doesn't have all the downforce it needs to go through a turn at its usual rate of speed. So your car will be understeering a bit more, which will contribute to the tire wear. Is it going to be really bad tire wear? No. Once again, you're on racing hard tires, and in this case, the tire multiplier is pretty low, so it's not going to present much of an issue. And we'll quickly take a look at the final lap, or towards the end of the final lap. Taking a look at the bottom left-hand corner of the screen, the tire wear and the fuel usage, not an issue at all. This is a pretty much an easy no-stop race. You don't need to go to the pit stop at all. Now we do need to talk about the cars to use for this race, and we are using a couple of different cars. So as you saw earlier in the video, we used the 2016 Audi R18 for the qualifying time trial, but for the race, we are using the Toyota TS050. Now, why is this the case? With the 2016 Audi R18, which I'll show in a bit in this clip, its boost is insane, which is where it gets the crazy acceleration, and that's what's going to help it get an amazing lap time. However, as early as lap 2, the battery is going to have a hard time trying to regenerate more than what it's using, and for example right here, the Audi R18 is going to run out of charge early on, and it's going to make it a sitting duck. So in places where the Audi R18 needs the boost later on in the race, the car is not going to have enough of it to make the boost last that entire section, which is going to make it a lot slower later on in the race. So in lap 1, it'll be really fast, but laps 2 and on, it's going to struggle a lot, and it's going to struggle to get the best times possible. And that's going to allow cars like the Porsche 919 Hybrid, which is what you're seeing right now, and the Toyota TS050 to dominate it in the race. Speaking of the 919 Hybrid, this car is also not going to be the go-to car because it doesn't have the top-end speed and you really need it for a track like Spa. And it will have the battery charge to be able to quickly accelerate out of the turns, but once that boost is off, that's where the disadvantage for the 919 Hybrid really comes in. So we're still in the 919 Hybrid for this clip, and the Audi R18 is just ahead of us. He's going to run out of the boost, so the 919 Hybrid, with its more efficient charging, is going to be able to easily overtake the Audi R18. But once it gets to 6th and 7th gears, it's not going to have any of the top end speed, which is going to allow the Audi R18, who is not using any of the battery charge, who ran out of it, to quickly catch up to it and overtake it once again. So the Porsche 919 Hybrid, it forgets how to go fast once it goes on to the later gears. Now, what makes the Toyota TS050 so good under the race pace? Well, its recharge rate is so good that you practically don't have to worry about running out of battery charge. All you have to do, once again, is bring the brake balance towards the rear of the car. That way, the battery charge can recharge a bit faster, and that also applies to the other hybrid LMP1 cars. Bring the brake balance towards the back of the car, and you're pretty much good to go. Don't have to worry about running out of battery charge. And even though this car doesn't have the highest top-end speed out of the LMP1 cars, it's still not as slow as the 919 hybrid, so you're not going to be facing too many problems from cars like the Audi R18, and that is if they even have any battery charge left. But yeah, this car, it just has so good of a recharge rate that you don't have to worry about running out of charge, and that's going to make your life a little bit easier. And this car can be really consistent with its lap times, and part of that is just because its battery charge will always be there for you whenever you need it. Finally, let's talk about places to overtake. So this first turn can be a place to get an overtake done, but you need to make sure that it really sticks, because it can be really easy to get re-overtaking again since you are approaching the camel straight. And also, you want to make sure you don't go too wide into our Rouge Rodillion. Hopefully I'm saying that right. Otherwise, you guys will be slowing each other down. And camel straight, here we are. You can get a really good overtake through here because of the slipstream. You're going to be going a lot faster. Make sure you brake a little early if you are under the slipstream. Try to make that overtake stick. Try to get ahead of the car that you're trying to overtake, as if you guys end up slowing each other down, you can be at a disadvantage as you approach this turn right here. This turn right here can be another place to get an overtake done. So let's fast forward through this. If someone gets a bad exit through these turns, it is possible to try to overtake them right around here. Once again, you just need to try to make sure that you can get the overtake to stick. Otherwise, you guys are going to be slowing yourself down, especially as you guys are approaching the back straight. And finally, the last place to try to get an overtake done is before you approach the bus stop chicane. You want to try to get ahead of them as soon as you can. Try to secure the apexes so they don't have a reply and try to re-overtake you or just take space away from you. But that is pretty much it for this guide. Once again, this is a no-stop race. Use the 2016 Audi R18 for the qualifying session, and then switch on over to the Toyota TS050 when you're ready to do the race. But that is all from me, and I just want to thank you guys again for the amazing support these past 2 years. And we just hit 10,000 subscribers on Sunday, which was a really awesome birthday gift. Can't believe that they aligned together so well right there. But anyways, that is all from me. I'm going to sign off now. So this is Mr. MCA. Thank you all for the amazing support and for the 10,000 subscribers. And I'll see you all in the next video.